Hello guys, this is Blitzy. Man, we're gonna try and do some guitar today. I've been playing for about 14 years on and off, and lately, you know, we're doing it again. And I've been teaching a few friends of mine over the webcam, so we're gonna try and see if that works for YouTube or whatever. And then, man, we'll just start out with something easy. We're gonna try and do Sweet Home Alabama. You know, it's a nice song to play, and hopefully it's not as hard as it sounds. Sweet Home Alabama is a song that's played on multiple guitars, so we're gonna focus on, you know, just gonna try and get something recognizable out of here. Let me switch on the amp and everything, and we'll get started. Make sure your guitar is tuned up all the way and everything. And then let's go to the guitar. So, let me give you open E there to tune to. Open A. Open D. G. B. And the E. And then let me just play it once. That's basically what we're going for. And let's see how far we get. It's basically three chords the whole song through. First chord is D, just D major, which starts at a open D string, so that would be the fourth string. We got finger 1, 2, 3, 4, so you know that. Finger 1 goes on the G string on fret 2. Then finger 3 goes on the B string on fret 3. And finger 2 goes on the low E string on fret 2. And what we're using from this chord is the open string, which we will give two downstrokes. And then we'll strike the B string and then the G string, so we're going up. And you let that ring. Then the next chord is a C, and normally we would play C like this. But we're playing it like this now. So we got finger 3 on the C note on the A string. So that's fret 3 on the A string for finger 2. Then finger 1 goes behind there on fret 2 on the D string. And we got an open G string then. And then finger 3 goes on the B string on fret 3. And what we're using from this chord is the same pattern as the D string, only the bass note will now be on the A string. So we're gonna have two downstrokes on the A string here on fret 3. And then you'll hear the B string on fret 3 on finger 3. And then your open G string. And then we're gonna go to a normal G chord. Which will do the same pattern again. So we got finger 2 on the low E string on fret 3. Finger 1 is on fret 2 of the A string, then we got an open D string, open G string, then finger 3 is on fret 3 of the B string, and our little pinky finger 4 is on fret 3 of the high E string. And we'll do and then the whole chord. So it's the bass note again, then the B and the G string, and then when you put it together it will sound like. Looking at the picking, it's on the D chord, open D string, then with an upstroke to the B string, and then you strike down on the G string. Then you do the same thing for the A string on the C chord. Upstroke B string, downstroke G string, and then for D, G, we are on the low E string twice, and then we just strike down on the high notes. Then there's a little lick that comes after this, which makes it sound nice, and that's a hammer-on. Which sounds like this. And that's hammer on with finger 1 to 2 on the A string, 0 to 2. Then on the D string, 0, 2, pull off to 0 again. Back to hammer on. And then we go back to the D string on 2. So. So hammer on 2 on the A string, hammer on 2 pull off on the D string, 0 2 on the A string, 0 2 on the D string, and back to your open D chord. Notice that finger 3 is always staying on the same fret here, so that's sort of an anchor. Now they do a massive amount of little licks in between. Like that sort of stuff. We'll do that another time. Just get this basic 3 chord bit down. The rest of the song just stays to these chords, so it will remain D, C. Hope you enjoy it. Check you later.